Check one, two. Check one, two, three, four. We're up a little high. Check one, two, three, four. Check one, two, three. We're going to put those up there. Okay, let's see if we can play this interview. My recordings, audio copy, my recordings. Nobody can hear me. I am here with UAH head coach Andrea Lemon. Coach, a week ago, this team had all the momentum in the world. You come off two impressive wins, and then you have all the momentum in the world. I am here with you. Check one, two, three, four. Good. Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Kelly Ford at Dragons Hall. In today's women's basketball contest, your Chargers will take on the Buccaneers from Christian Brothers University. Fans are wearing face coverings required at all times alongside Dragons Hall. Please also use your equipment at some center stations that are located throughout the concourses.
The University of Alabama is the North-South Conference, and the NCAA offers more displayed by student athletes, coaches, and spectators. We request your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner.
Profanity, racial or sexist comments, or other intimidating words or actions
directed at officials, student athletes, coaches, or as team representatives
will not be tolerated in the Royal Family Room Spread and Health.
We'd also like to remind you that UAA is a tobacco-free camp.
And the consumption of alcoholic beverages is strictly prohibited.
Thank you, enjoy the game, and go Chargers.
Go Chargers.
Go Chargers.
Go Chargers.
Good afternoon, I should say, and welcome in to UAH Charger basketball. Charger women getting ready to take on Christian Brothers. And just a short time ago, we had a chance to catch up with UAH head coach Andrea Lemon. Here's the coach's thoughts on today's game. I am here with UAH head coach Andrea Lemon. Coach, a week ago, this team had all the momentum in the world. You come off two impressive wins, and then you have to hit the pause button. How has the team kind of handled the momentum swing and then the adversity of not being able to play?
Well, I think they're hungry. You know, we had a slow start. We hadn't had everybody healthy pretty much all year until the beginning of January. Like you said, those two road wins on Gulf South at Montevallo and Shorter, I mean, we finally started kind of feeling like ourselves a little bit in the groove, kind of getting a little confidence, and then boom, we're kind of knocked right back to square one, or actually dismissed from campus for a few days. Yeah. But I think it made them just a little bit hungrier. I think they've been watching a little bit more film since they hadn't been able to be in the gym for a few days, and they're ready. I mean, all of them were here about 2.5 hours before tip-off, like ready to go. They showed up today 30 minutes before our film session. I was like, what are y'all doing here? They're just ready to get back on the court.
Well, let's go through those two games. First, the Montevallo game. That was a grind-out game, and then you get to Shorter, and really you can see this team starting to hit that stride.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we really miss like Holly Harris and Alexis Woods at the beginning of the season. And Holly really came on strong for us at Shorter. She ended up with 17 points at Shorter. But I tell you who stepped up, too. Obviously, Jessie Jennings, our freshman for us, she made huge plays that probably didn't even show up.
We'll hear more from head coach Andrea Lemon here. Quarter, and really you can see this team starting to hit that stride.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we really miss like Holly Harris and Alexis Woods at the beginning of the season. And Holly really came on strong for us at Shorter. She ended up with 17 points at Shorter. But I tell you who stepped up, too. Obviously, Alexis had 18 rebounds at Shorter. Jessie Jennings, our freshman for us, she made huge plays that probably didn't even show up on a stat sheet that really kind of changed the momentum of the game for us at Shorter. So I was just proud of our kids just to kind of battle it out. And at the Montevallo game, you know, after not having everybody healthy for the entire year, we rotated every single player on our team into that game. So it made it very special for us to be able to have all 13 players on the court for that first win.
How hard has it been for Holly to come in and try not to do too much so fast after having to watch, I guess you could say, a fourth of the season on the bench?
Holly just, she's one of the smartest players I've ever coached. She's probably a lot smarter than I am when it comes to just a lot of the things that she sees that I don't see. That there's so much that she does that does not show up on a stat sheet. Even when she's not scoring the ball, she may be frustrated, but I have to pull her to the side and like, look, you don't see, I see all the other things that you're doing. Even if the other people don't see it, you make a huge impact on the defensive end, on the offensive end, But no, I really think she stepped in and really not missed a beat. I think she's a little bit frustrated with her shot not falling the way she's used to it falling. But she's had a good week of practice and the shot looks good.
Does that come with timing and does that come with more game reps?
I think so, for sure. I mean, she was sidelined for 6 weeks, you know, and not really able to do anything except stationary shooting. Well, it's a lot different when it's game speed, game light. You got somebody running at you with hands in your face. So I think she's getting more confident in that.
Well, you look ahead, especially to today's game. Christian Brothers comes to town. Another chance for you guys to string together another successful game, put all that momentum together in a very winnable ball game.
Yeah, I think so. Christian Brothers, they're a very tough team. They're going to play very fast. We got to be ready to get out ahead of them in transition, slow them down so they don't get easy buckets. Because make or miss, they're ripping that ball out of the net and they're going. So we can't relax. We can't celebrate. We got to get back. We got to keep our legs under us. And they put five people out there that can shoot it from beyond the arc and they can take it off the bounce. Really put four big guards out there. So it could be a little bit of a challenge for our post players not used to guarding on the arc. But they're going to have to guard our post players on the inside too.
I was just going to say that really it's about what you do and what UAH does. So how do you game plan this to be successful?
I think, you know, with them not really having just a true power post, and we do, really with three of our post players, they lead us in field goal percentage. And we've seen a lot of double teaming the post and triple teaming the post because of that. And that's something that we definitely worked on over the break. Because we know we're going to see that some more. So if we do see the trapping inside, we'll have a little bit better game plan for it as opposed to, all right, let's just not feed the post because we don't want to get in a situation
right
where we're not giving Alexis Woods the ball on the block or Jaira Rogers the ball on the block.
You look at the schedule and there's still time. I mean, every game is important for this group, but you could not be getting healthy. You could not be getting everybody back at the right time. You're making that final push in the schedule. I mean, we're down, I believe, what, 10 maybe conference games left?
After this one, yep, this is number 9. So we'll have 10 after this one. So, yeah, there's a lot of basketball left. And you never know what's going to happen during this time of the year. But, yeah, like you said, this is when you want to be hitting a stride and gaining some confidence. So it's good that during this time we got everybody healthy and this is not the time that everybody's dropping off.
All right, well, good luck today, Coach.
All right, thank you.
That was UAH head coach Andrea Lemon ahead of today's contest. UAH Chargers getting ready to take on Christian Brothers here inside the stable on the campus of UAH. Chargers come in, as we mentioned, feeling real good about themselves. A 2-game win streak with wins on the road at Montevallo. And then they followed that one up with a win over Shorter, a 76-73 win January 8th. We now pause for the national anthem. Welcome in once again. The UAH Chargers getting ready to take on Christian Brothers here at home this afternoon. This game is a rescheduled game. The two were originally supposed to play last week, but that one was postponed along with the Union game. Starting lineups now being introduced for both teams. Christian Brothers going with Isabella Jones, a 5'11" sophomore out of Memphis, Tennessee. Carly Bates, a 5'7" sophomore out of Arlington, Tennessee. Emily Jones, a 6-foot sophomore out of Jackson, Tennessee, gets the start.
Heart of a lion, fire inside me blaze like a siren. Why would you try it? Wake up the beast, no, I can't keep silent. I put my time in, now it's my time, your time is expiring. Blood, sweat, and tears, I conquer my fears, I'm ready to fly now. I am the pilot, I am so polished, usually modest, but when is the last time you seen it this stylish, without a stylist, huh? It's been a long time, I've been on this road, I'm racking my mileage up. They don't get loud with us, cause they know we wild, we know they scared of us. No, they don't care for us, they wasn't there for us. Up in them trenches, hopping them fences, making the plays while they riding the benches, yeah. Got cool intentions, yeah, I see my goal and get cold in December. When counting our sins, I don't have no friends, I came here to win. My start is your end, now let it begin now. Get loud for me.
Alexis Woods, those are the five starting for the UAH Chargers. Zelina Pruitt comes in leading the way for UAH, averaging 11.2 points per game. Miesha Bullitt comes in second on the team, 10.4 points per game. Holly Harris, 8.4. Holly just starting, as you heard head coach Andrea Lemon in the pregame, just starting to get that shooting touch back. Just 3 of 21 from behind the three-point arc. So hopefully today a little home cooking can make Holly Harris get that shooting touch back. 10 minutes is on the clock, and we are ready to play UAH basketball on a Tuesday afternoon here on the campus of UAH. This one is a big one for the Chargers. You managed to get a win here today, and you have three conference wins with 10 to go. Anything is possible down the stretch for the Chargers. Christian Brothers led by Jesse Carmack in her third season as head coach. The five on the floor again for Christian Brothers: Isabella Jones, Emily Jones, Carly Bates, Yaya Coleman, and Darcy Doran. Those are the five on the floor for Christian Brothers. UAH controls the tip. Selena Pruitt over to Holly Harris. Holly gets everyone set up to the right side to Miesha Bullock. Bullock trying to find some room, gives it up to Sloan Mann. 20 on the clock. Harris directing traffic to the right side is Sloan Mann, looking down low to Miesha. Miesha Bullock drives off the glass for two. The Chargers out of the gates fast. Miesha Bullock, the first two, leading the way. Back from Christian Brothers, Coleman gives it up over to Bates. Bates over to Coleman. Coleman over to Jemily Jones. Back down to Coleman. Coleman makes a move. Kicks it back outside. Isabella Jones thought about the three. No. Gives it up to Coleman. Coleman with eight on the clock. Guarded by Alexis Woods. Gives it up over to Isabella Jones. Two on the shot clock. They're not going to get it off. That's a shot clock violation. So the UAH defense stands tall early, forcing the shot clock violation. That is turnover number one. Sloan Mann over to Bullock along the right side, directing traffic, trying to kick it down low to Alexis Woods. Over to Sloan Mann, 18 on the clock. Bullock, top of the key. Selena Pruitt, the long three, rattles it in, you betcha. Selena Pruitt, her 23rd made three of the season, and it's a 5-0 Chargers lead. Christian Brothers, the long three from Emily Jones is good. Emily Jones gonna get Christian Brothers on the board with the three. Bullock spins, loses control, gets control. Alexis Woods gets it. And no, a lot of contact there on Alexis Woods, but no call. Down low, Jones, the little turnaround spin move is good for Emily Jones. So just as fast as the Chargers started, Christian Brothers answers back and we are tied at five. Sloan man down. Holly Harris going to let the three ball go. You betcha, Holly Harris from the corner. Holly Harris hits the three and the Chargers regain the lead 8-5. Emily Jones along the right side coming off a three. Coleman will take the three off the mark. Harris with the rebound and we are going the other way. Selena Pruitt racing into the lane. The scoop lay-in is good. Selena Pruitt's got five on the day, and the Chargers up five, 10-5. With 7:20 left to go here in the first quarter. To the right side, Isabella Jones over to Coleman. Coleman gives it up to Carly Bates. Down low to Jones, being guarded by Holly Harris, and Harris forces the jump ball. Alternate possession going to stay in favor of Christian Brothers. Just underneath their basket along the right side. The inbound pass over to Jones. Jones trying to find some space, and Sloan Mann going to get called for the foul.
Fouls on number 15, Sloan Mann.
So that is Sloan Mann's first. That is UAH's first here in the first. So with 7:06 left to go, Chargers enjoying a 10-5 lead. A little Tuesday afternoon basketball. Christian Brothers to inbound it on the far side. Nowhere to go, and that's 5 seconds. So the Chargers defense has forced two turnovers here in the first quarter. A shot clock violation, and there a 5-second call. So Chargers inbound it. Selena Pruitt brings it across the timeline. Kicks it over to the left side for Sloan Mann. Sloan trying to find Alexis Woods down low. Gives it over to Miesha Bullock. Holly Harris from the other corner. You betcha, Holly Harris. That's two threes on the day for Holly Harris. She's got six. Chargers up 13-5. Here comes Christian Brothers. That's Yaya Coleman. A little out of control there was Coleman. Foul, though, is going to be called on Holly Harris. That is her first, the team's second. So Harris with a pair of three. So far, the Chargers have 3 three-pointers here in the first. The little scoop from Jeremiah Montgomery, and she is going to get called for the foul. Montgomery nowhere to go there. Gonna give the ball back to the Chargers. Jesse Jennings, the freshman, has checked in. And the Bullock pass is gonna be stolen away, and Jones is gonna walk with it. Emily Jones had a clear path, but she walked there to get to it. So that's another turnover. Chargers up 13-5. Jennings gonna bring the ball across the court. Holly Harris, Sloan Mann, Alexis Woods, Jesse Jennings, and Miesha Bullock. Your five on the floor for UAH. A little jabber rolls in for Sloan Mann. She's on the board. Her first field goal of the game. The Chargers up 10. Back comes Emily Jones the other way. That's Christian Brothers' leading scorer, averaging just over 19 points a game. Drives the lane. She's going to be fouled. And that's going to be on Sloan Mann, her second third team foul. So Emily Jones has the line shooting two, where she is an 85% free throw shooter. First one up is good. Second one is up and good as well.
Checking into the game for UAH, number four.
So Emily Jones has a pair of free throws. She now has 4 points on the day. Elena Taylor checks in for the Chargers for the first time, as does Olivia Howard. Adrian Grant also in the game for the Chargers. So four new ones on the floor. Holly Harris still out there as well. Grant down low, over to Taylor. Taylor over to Howard. Howard over to Harris. Harris will set the offense up with 10. Jennings finds, tries to get it down low to Adrian Grant, but the pass is off the mark, and here comes Christian Brothers. Chargers enjoying an 8-point lead here in the first. The cross-court pass to Jones. Good. Emily Jones, the three. She's got 7 of the Cologne. Christian Brothers, 10. There goes Taylor over to Jennings. Jennings going to give it down low to Howard. Howard's jumper off the mark, and Adrian Grant going to get called for over the back. That's Grant's first. That is the fourth team foul for UAH. Selena Pruitt checks back in. Selena having to play with a mask on today, as is Olivia Howard. So here comes Christian Brothers. Carly Bates brings it across the timeline. Over to Jeremiah Montgomery. Gives it over to Yaya Coleman. Coleman being guarded by Bullock. A little step move up and no good. Selena Pruitt comes away with a rebound, and we are off to the races. Selena Pruitt tries to get to the baseline, but she's cut off. Gives it over to Jennings. Jennings to Taylor. Taylor directing traffic to Bullock, and the pass going to be tipped, nearly stolen from Jeremiah Montgomery. Chargers able to maintain possession. We've got our first media timeout. Chargers enjoying a 5-point lead, 15-10. Let's hear.
Hello, Charger fans. This is Cade Smith, UAH Director of Athletics. You're listening to Charger Basketball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Keep up with the latest news and photos of all of our teams on UAHChargers.com and by subscribing to our email newsletter. Also, don't forget to follow us on social media at UAH Chargers. Thank you for supporting our wonderful student athletes. We look forward to seeing you at one of our upcoming games. Go Chargers.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
Ryan Bell, Me State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Ryan Bell, Me State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at BrianBellamyAgency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
And welcome back to the stable, UAH, Christian Brothers, UAH with the basket right there. Makes it a 17-10 ball game. Back comes Christian Brothers. And that, Yaya Coleman for three. She is now on the board. Alexis Woods with the last basket for the Chargers. It's going to be Taylor along the left side. Kicks it down low to Alexis Woods. Up and in for Alexis Woods, plus one. Back-to-back trips for Alexis Woods with a basket. She's got 4 in the game. Alexis now will head to the free throw line, where she is a 66% free throw shooter looking to complete the 3-point play. It is up and no good for Alexis. But Christian Brothers, that would be Emily Jones and Jeremiah Montgomery, collide. And we've got a travel call, so the ball turned back over to UAH. So the Chargers can add to the six-point lead, up 19-13 with 3:52 left. Down low to Alexis Woods. The ball gets tipped out of bounds. Going to stay UAH basketball. Alexis comes in averaging 12 points a game, 6.9 rebounds per game. Obviously, a big effort to get the ball down low to Alexis Woods today. Selena Pruitt directs traffic, 20 on the clock, on the shot clock. Holly Harris along the left side. She's got a pair of threes already here in the first. Taylor trying to get the ball down low to Alexis Woods, has it tipped. Christian Brothers with numbers. Now everybody is back, five aside. Coleman drives, kicks it out for the long three for Bates. No good, the rebounds. Up and in by Darcy Doran. Chargers failed to box out, and Darcy Doran found a lot of wide open real estate. And she gets the and one. Fouls on Alexis Woods, that is her first. Fifth team foul for UAH. Lena Taylor comes out, and for the first time today, Abby Holly checks in. So Selena Pruitt, Holly Harris, Miesha Bullock, Alexis Woods, and Abby Holly on the floor for the Chargers. Holly kicks it over to Holly Harris along the right side. Nowhere to go for Holly, and she's going to get tipped and bumped. Foul's going to be on Darcy Doran, her first, third team foul for Christian Brothers. 3:12 left to go here in the first. Chargers on top, 19-16. Selena Pruitt hands it off to Miesha Bullock. Over to Holly Harris. Harris over to Abby Holly. Kicks it down low. Holly Harris trying to find Alexis Woods down low, and that pass just a little too strong as it goes out of bounds. So Christian Brothers has a chance to tie with a three here in the first. Down three, 19-16. The drive from Carly Bates, kicks it out to Jones. Gives it over to Jeremiah Montgomery. Montgomery nowhere to go, and the steal from Holly Harris. We're going the other way. Harris lays it off the mark. Holly Harris, she's smiling coming down the floor knowing she missed the lay-in. The three from Bates, no good, rattles around. Last touch by Alexis Wood, so we'll stay here. So the Chargers looking good here in the first right now. Enjoying that three-point lead, 19-16. Miesha Bullock checks out. Sloan Mann checks back in. Christian Brothers on the inbounds, kicks it down low to Coleman. Coleman's turnaround jumper, hard off the iron, no good. And Alexis Woods comes away with the rebound. Jesse Jennings brings it across the timeline, sets the Chargers up in the offense, gives it over to Sloan Mantle on the right side. Man over, and the drive from Abby Holly is taken away. Christian Brothers on the move. That's Bailey McMath, hands it off, and McMath takes it again. She's going to set Columbus Brothers up. Christian Brothers, I should say, with 15 on the shot clock. Gives it over to Doran. Doran's going to drive, be cut off at the lane. The long three is no good from Montgomery. And Holly Harris controls the rebound. And Coach Andrea Levin giving some instructions to Jesse Jennings. Over to Holly Harris along the left side. Harris backs her way down. Pass gets tipped out of bounds. UAH will main. No. That looked like it was tipped out of bounds, but it was not. So that is a turnover for the Chargers. We're still 19-16. UAH out in front. UAH's largest lead here in the first has been 10 when it was 15-5. Here comes Christian Brothers. That's McMath along the right-hand side. Over to Montgomery. Montgomery going to find Doran along the left side. That's Dorn for three, and the tie rams in and out. No good. Holly Harris controls the rebound. Gives it over to Jesse Jennings along the right side. Down low to Adrian Grant. Grant tries to make a move in the paint. Up and that ball bounces about five times on the rim and bounces out. Here comes Christian Brothers in the corner. Dorn thought about the three, but checks up. McMath down low to a wide open Montgomery. And that is two. 19-18, Chargers holding on to that one-point lead. It's been a little bit since we've had our last field goal. We're due. 20 on the shot clock, 23 on the game clock. Holly Harris drives, hard off the glass, no good. Adrian Grant trying to control the rebound, has it taken away on the floor. And here comes Christian Brothers, 3-on-2. Montgomery, the lay-in is good. Christian Brothers takes their first lead of the game, 20-19, 4 on the game clock. Sloan Mann at the buzzer, no good. And it will be Christian Brothers leading after one, 20-19. Here is a word from Bryant Bank.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. It is UAH basketball. Chargers at home taking on Christian Brothers. We get ready to start the second quarter. Chargers trailing 19-20. UAH going through a dry spell there to end the first. Christian Brothers with their first lead of the game at 20-19. Jesse Jennings tries to find Selena Pruitt on the left side, but has it taken away. A 3-on-1 break for Christian Brothers. And McMath nowhere to go. She's going to get fouled. So UAH had it going on early, but some turnovers have let Christian Brothers get back into this one and ultimately take the lead. The foul's on Olivia Howard. That is her first. Actually, my bad, that foul's on Selena Pruitt, her first, team's first here of the second, and McMath makes two free throws to extend the lead to 3 for Christian Brothers. McMath, a 66% free throw shooter. Selena Pruitt's lay-in is no good. Back comes Christian Brothers, pushing the tempo. A wide open three from Coleman, good. Yeah, Coleman makes it a 25-19 lead. Now UAH really needs to find the bottom of the basket. Maybe it's time for Holly Harris or Miesha Bullock. She drives, loses control, and it's a 4-on-1 Christian Brothers break. The pull-up jumper too strong. Adrian Grant comes down with a rebound over to Miesha Bullock. Somebody needs to step up and make a field goal. Selena Pruitt over to Miesha Bullock. Bullock's going to drive. Going to try to find Adrian Grant, who throws it inbounds, but has it taken away. Back come Chargers, and Jesse Jennings tips it out of ball. Tips it out of bounds, I should say. Chargers having a hard time holding on to the ball. Right now, UAH with 10 turnovers in the game. The long three from Coleman, good. Yaya Coleman with the three, and Andrea Lemon needs a timeout. Chargers down 9, 28-19, and we'll take it with them.
Want to try something different for breakfast, lunch, or dinner? Then why not head on over to City Cafe Diner? They have the largest menu in the area with traditional breakfast like pancakes and omelets, comfort foods like burgers and shakes, and specialty items like homemade Greek delicacies. And their entire menu is served any time of day. So make plans to dine with City Cafe Diner today, just west of the parkway at 2003 Drake Avenue. City Cafe Diner, where no one leaves hungry.
Tom Luganville here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Welcome back to the campus of UAH, the Chargers. Women taking on Christian Brothers, and UAH with a little work to do here in the second. 8:39 left to go. UAH down 28-19. The Chargers have led by as many as 10 in this one, but have gone ice cold from the floor, needing the basket in a big way. Selena Pruitt, 17 on the shot clock. Over to Miesha Bullock. Bullock spins into the lane. The reverse lay-in is no good, but Bullock gonna be fouled. The Chargers did enjoy a 10-point lead in this one as they were on top 15-5. Since then, UAH has been outscored 23-4. So Christian Brothers on a 23-4 run. And Miesha Bullock ends that run with the free throw. So it's now a 28-20 Christian Brothers lead. The second one is up and good from Bullock. Bullock, an 80% free throw shooter on the season, gives the Chargers their first 2 points. So back comes Christian Brothers. Over to Jones, to McMath. Chargers in a man-man defense. We're going to get an offensive foul, an illegal screen. That is going to be the first on Yaya Coleman, her first, team's second foul. So the five on the floor for UAH, Holly Harris, Selena Pruitt, Miesha Bullock, Alexis Woods, and Sloan Mann. That is your starting five back on the floor for the Chargers. Got off to a hot start. Harris for the long three off the back of the iron, no good. And down comes Isabella Jones with the rebound. Here comes Christian Brothers. Gives it over to Chloe Crawford. Crawford going to drive the lane. Kicks it out to the long three from Emily Jones is good. So it's now a 10-point Christian Brothers lead, 31-21. Chargers still need a field goal. They got two free throws from Miesha Bullock, but it's been a while since that ball's gone into the net. Selena Pruitt will try to end it, and she does. The long three from the corner from Selena Pruitt. It's now a 7-point game, and Holly Harris nearly the turnover. The ball falls into Isabella Jones's hands, and she lays it in for two. So Chargers now down 9. Here comes Holly Harris, drives the left side. She's going to get pushed. Holly Harris got pushed out of bounds. Isabella Jones picks up the foul, her first, team's third. So Chargers inbounded along the left side. Selena Pruitt over to Miesha Bullock. Bullock nowhere to go, kicks it back over to Pruitt. Back over to Bullock, getting into the hands of Holly Harris. Harris will take that three, you betcha. Off the mark was Holly Harris. That was well within Holly Harris's range, just can't quite get the three to go, but we've got a foul, so we'll stay here. Foul's gonna be on Christian Brothers' Anna Uhalem, her first, team's fourth. So the Chargers get another crack at it. 20 on the shot clock. Pruitt over to Sloan Mann, over to Holly Harris. Over to Miesha Bullock. Bullock nowhere to go with the ball, has to give it up over to Harris. 5 on the clock. Pruitt will take the long three. You betcha, Selena Pruitt. That's back-to-back threes for Pruitt. And the Chargers cutting into the deficit. Back comes Christian Brothers. The three is good from Chloe Crawford. And so Christian Brothers answers our three with a three of their own, pushing the lead back to 9. Holly Harris trying the cross-court pass to Selena Pruitt. Pruitt wide open baseline and has that one roll in and out. And on the fight for the offensive rebound, Alexis Woods going to get fouled. Anna Ehala with the foul. That is her second. That's the 15th foul. So Alexis Woods will head to the free throw line. 's first one is up and good. So Woods comes in averaging 12 points a game, 66% free throw shooter. And the second one is up and good. Woods now has 6 in the game. So Chargers trailing 29-36 with 5:38 left to go. That's Emily Jones, kicks it on up to Doran. Doran kicks it out to Anna Ehala, and that's an easy jumper. So the Chargers give up the easy jumper and now find themselves down 9 once again. The long three from Sloan Mann, well off the mark. Ball goes out of bounds, back over to Christian Brothers. So both teams have led by as many as 10. Christian Brothers can go up by 11 with a basket here as they lead 38-29. Kick out to Doran from the corner for 3. Good. Darcy Doran for 3. Came in shooting 32% from behind the arc. Makes it a 41-29 game. Holly Harris along the left side. Tries to find some space. No good. It gives it over to Sloan Mann, and she steps on the out-of-bounds line. That is going to turn it back over to Christian Brothers. They can add to their 12-point lead with 4:35 left to go here before the half. That's Carly Bates being guarded over by Elena Taylor. Bates going to drive right side on Taylor, off the glass and good. Carly Bates lays it off the glass, and it's a 43-29 Christian Brothers lead. Elena Taylor along the left side. Nowhere to go. Watch the ball roll off her shoe, and we've got a jump ball. So the Chargers have problems holding on to the ball. As they turn it over yet again, uncharacteristically, Chargers turning the ball over. That is 11 turnovers for the Chargers here in the first half. Over to Emily Jones along the left side. Over, gives it over to Carly Bates. Bates over to Doran. Doran looks like she got away with a carry right there. Emily Jones drives, finds some real estate, tries to spin it off the glass. No, but she's going to head to the line. So a combination of UAH having a hard time scoring consistently here in the first half and a problem with turnovers resulted in a 43-29 deficit. Emily Jones rattles one in, the first of 2. Jones comes in an 85% free throw shooter on the season. Jones' second one rims out. Jones has 12 on the game, but Christian Brothers comes away with the rebound and they can add to the lead. A little spin around jumper, no good by Coleman, and UAH comes away with it. Here comes Selena Pruitt along the right side. Chargers have some work to do, but they can make it up in a hurry. And number 12 can do it. Holly Harris drives the scoop. No good, but Harris going to head to the free throw line. Foul's going to be on Emily Jones. That is her first. Fifth team foul for Christian Brothers here in the second. And that'll send Holly Harris to the free throw line. Holly just getting her legs under. 61% free throw shooter. Of course, Holly missed about 6 weeks of the season. The first one up and just a little bit hard off the iron. So Harris will get one more. Second one is up and good for Harris. So the Chargers trail 44-30 with 3:17 left to go before the half. See if they can get a run together here to get this below double digits before the break. Along the right-hand side, that's Bates. Gives it over to Coleman. Coleman drives on Miesha Bullock. No good. Ball rattling around. Doran going to end up with it. 17 on the shot clock. Emily Jones drives. Kicks it over to Coleman. Coleman into the lane. A lot of contact. Coleman went in hard. A lot of contact. And Coleman down on the ground. She's fine. That's going to be the second foul on Alexis Woods, her second, team's third here. So Abby Holly checks back in, Selena Pruitt getting a break. Pruitt again having to play with a mask on today, as is Olivia Howard. But Yaya Coleman at the line for Christian Brothers. The first one rims out, no good. Coleman with one more chance to add to the 14-point lead for Christian Brothers. Second one up and good. So it's now a 45-30 game with 2:50 left to go before the half. Chargers again going through a offensive dry spell. Jump ball. UAH maintains the possession, so Abby Holly will inbound just to the right of her basket. Got to reset the shot clock. It should be, there we go, 30 on the shot clock. Holly nowhere to go, kicks it out to Bullock. Bullock over to Jennings. Jennings gives it back to Holly, down low to Sloan Mann, the little jumper. Off the mark, but Miesha Bullock is there for the putback. Miesha Bullock, the basket for the Chargers. That's a 45-32 game. Emily Jones drives, nowhere to go. Cut off at the free throw line by Sloan Mann. Bullock going for the steal, nearly comes away with it. Coleman drives, that's got to be offensive. Yep, Yaya Coleman out of control. And Jesse Jennings there to take it. That's going to be the second on Coleman. And the Chargers now with 2:12 left to go, trailing by 13, 45-32, have a chance to cut into it even further. Holly along the right side, gives it over to Bullock and taken away. Christian Brothers read that pass perfectly from Abby Holly. Took the ball away and raced the other way, did Carly Bates. And Abby Holly commits the foul. That is her first, fourth team foul. So that will send Carly Bates back to the free throw line. Again, a 65% free throw shooter. First one up and good for Carly Bates. So Bates with the second one up and good for Carly Bates. So Bates makes both. It is now a 47-32 Christian Brothers lead with 2:01 left to go before the half. Largest lead for Christian Brothers in this one, 15. Chargers enjoyed a 10-point lead in the first. Alexis Woods off the glass for two. So with 1:43, UAH making another run, maybe. Alexis has six in the game. UAH right now led by Selena Pruitt. She has 11. The Chargers 34. It's Holly Harris, Miesha Bullock, Alexis Woods, Selena Pruitt, and Jesse Jennings on the floor. But that is Emily Jones for three, and it's now a 49-34 Charger deficit. Selena Pruitt tries to answer the three with her own. Off the mark, no good. The fight for the rebound goes Christian Brothers' way. Here comes CBU. The Buccaneers can grow that lead. It sits at 15. Jones gives it over. The long three from Coleman is no good, and Chargers take back over. Selena Pruitt across the timeline. Gives it over to Miesha Bullock. 52 on the game clock, 19 on the shot clock. Trying to find Alexis Woods down low is Jesse Jennings. No, Holly Harris, 10 on the shot clock. Harris makes a move, the dump pass to Alexis Woods, no good. Alexis Woods had the wide open look. Back comes Miesha Bullock with a steal. A 3-on-3 break, and Bullock takes it into the lane, makes contact. No, but she will head to the free throw line. Foul's going to be on Carly Bates. That is her second 15 foul. So we'll shoot two. Miesha Bullock will shoot two. Bullock with 6 points here in the first half. First one is up and good. Second one is up and off the front of the rim from Miesha Bullock. Carly Bates, top of the key. Across the timeline, gonna hold for the last shot. Being guarded by Selena Pruitt. 12 on the game clock. Shot clock is off. Alexis cuts off Bates. Over to Coleman. Coleman, the little 10-foot jumper. No good off the back of the iron. Holly Harris with two. Harris with the half-court heave off the mark. And the Chargers will head to the half, staring at a 49-35 deficit. Let's hear from Bryant Bank.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Ryan Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Ryan Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at BryantBellamyAgency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Ryan Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
Hello, Charger fans. This is Cade Smith, UA's Director of Athletics. You're listening to Charger Basketball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Keep up with the latest news and photos of all of our teams on uahchargers.com and by subscribing to our email newsletter. Also, don't forget to follow us on social media at UAH Chargers. Thank you for supporting our wonderful student athletes. We look forward to seeing you at one of our upcoming games. Go Chargers.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
And welcome back on the campus of UAH, the Chargers. Women taking on Christian Brothers this afternoon, and we are at the half. UAH trailing 49-35. Before the game, did have a chance to visit with UAH head coach Andrea Lemon to get her thoughts on today's game. Here is the coach. I am here with UAH head coach Andrea Lemon. Coach, a week ago, this team had all the momentum in the world. You come off two impressive wins, and then you have to hit the pause button. How has the team kind of handled the momentum swing and then the adversity of not being able to play?
Well, I think they're hungry. You know, we had a slow start. We hadn't had everybody healthy pretty much all year until the beginning of January. Like you said, those two road wins on Gulf South at Montevallo and Shorter, I mean, we finally started kind of feeling like ourselves a little bit in the groove, kind of getting a little confidence, and then, boom, we're kind of knocked right back to square one, or actually dismissed from campus for a few days. But I think it made them just a little bit hungrier. I think they've been watching a little bit more film since they hadn't been able to be in the gym for a few days, and they're ready. I mean, all of them were here about 2.5 hours before tip-off, like, ready to go. They showed up today 30 minutes before our film session. I was like, what are y'all doing here? They're just ready to get back on the court.
Well, let's go through those two games. First, the Montevallo game. That was a grind-out game, and then you get to Shorter, and really you can see this team starting to hit that stride.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, we really miss like Holly Harris and Alexis Woods the beginning of the season. And Holly really came on strong for us at Shorter. She ended up with 17 points at Shorter. But I tell you who stepped up, too. Obviously, Alexis had 18 rebounds at Shorter. Jessie Jennings, our freshman for us, she made huge plays that probably didn't even show up on a stat sheet that really kind of changed the momentum of the game for us at Shorter. So I was just proud of our kids just to kind of battle it out. And at the Montevallo game, you know, after not having everybody healthy for the entire year, we rotated every single player on our team into that game. So it made it very special for us to be able to have all 13 players on the court for that first win.
How hard has it been for Holly to come in and try not to do too much so fast after having to watch, I guess you could say, a fourth of the season on the bench?
Holly just... I've ever coached. She's probably a lot smarter than I am when it comes to just a lot of the things that she sees that I don't see. That there's so much that she does that does not show up on a stat sheet. Even when she's not scoring the ball, she may be frustrated, but I have to pull her to the side and like, look, you don't see it. I see all the other things that you're doing. Even if the other people don't see it, you make a huge impact on the defensive end, on the offensive end. But no, I really think she stepped in and really not missed a beat. I think she's a little bit frustrated with her shot.
Tara Tyson, or Tara Tyson's smiling face with hearts, man and woman kissing.
And indeed, welcome back to UAH basketball on the campus of UAH. The Chargers taking on Christian Brothers this afternoon. And we do want to welcome everyone that can follow us on Zone 2. If you head to the 97.7 ESPN The Zone app, you can hear us on Zone 2. UAH taking on Christian Brothers. 49-35, your halftime score. Let's run down the stat sheet. Let's run down the stat sheet, shall we? Chargers shooting 48% from the floor. Christian Brothers shooting 57% from three-point range. Christian Brothers 8 of 14. UAH 5 of 10. Christian Brothers 57%. UAH 50%. From the free throw line, Christian Brothers 66% or 81%. 9 of 11. UAH 66%, 6 of 9. Now, rebounding is where the Chargers have struggled all season. In fact, really, both teams have been struggling from rebounding, Christian Brothers and UAH. Christian Brothers comes in a minus 3.8 on the boards. UAH comes in minus 6.9. UAH being out-rebounded per game almost by 7. And the first half, UAH being out-rebounded by 4, 16-12. The story in this one, though, UAH would lead by 10, 15-5 at the 6-12 mark in the first. Christian Brothers would go on a run, and they lead 49-35 at the break. Turnovers, UAH committing 12 first-half turnovers. Christian Brothers, 9. Bench points, that is where UAH is being outscored 11-0 in the bench. Fast break points, UAH on top 4-0. Christian Brothers with 9 steals, 18 points off turnovers. So Christian Brothers doing a fantastic job of converting those 12 turnovers from UAH into points. Individually, Selena leading the Chargers with 11, Alexis Woods with 8, Emily Jones leading Christian Brothers with 14, Yaya Coleman with 10. Rebounding, Alexis Woods with 5 rebounds in the game. Christian Brothers, Yaya Coleman with 5. All right, so a minute and 52 seconds before we tip this one off. Let's hear from Brian Pake.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. 4 locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
And welcome back to the campus of UAH, the Chargers. The women taking on Christian Brothers. We're getting ready to start the second half. Same five on the floor for UAH that started the game. Alexis Woods, Holly Harris, Selena Pruitt, Sloan Mann, and Miesha Bullock. The five on the floor for Christian Brothers. Yaya Coleman, Darcy Doran, Emily Jones, Isabella Jones, and Carly Bates. So 10 minutes are on the clock, and we are ready to play basketball. Chargers have some work to do. Down 14, 49 to 35. Christian Brothers starts the ball in the second half. Down low to Bates. Kicks it out to Coleman. Ball going to be kicked, and we're going to stay here. So the Chargers have some work to do. And it starts here on the defensive end. You get a stop, you score a basket. Emily Jones being cut off at the lane, and that is an offensive foul. Miesha Bullock, the defensive stance right there. That is the second foul on Emily Jones. So here we go, UAH. 1 point at a time, we start chipping away. Miesha Bullock, no good. And the rebound goes to Christian Brothers. The outlet pass to Emily Jones. Jones being guarded by Bullock. Down low to Isabella Jones. Outline for three. Good. Yaya Coleman for three. It's all right. Let's go, UAH. We can get this. Deficit 52-35. Selena Pruitt double teamed. Holly Harris in the corner. Kicks it cross court over to Sloan Mann. 13 on the shot clock over to Bullock. Bullock trying to get it down low, nowhere to go. Sloan Mann, 5 on the shot clock. Holly Harris drives, the lay and high off the glass is good. Holly Harris comes back with two of her own. And here comes Christian Brothers right back down the court. Kicks it over to Emily Jones, the long three off the mark. Alexis Woods the rebound. Gives it over to Selena Pruitt. Another chance for the Chargers to cut into this deficit. Miesha Bullock along the left side. 19 on the clock. Bullock drives, tripped. That is a foul there. That's going to be on Darcy Doran. That is her second. Team's second here in the third. So Sloan Mann will inbound it just underneath her basket. 20 on the shot clock. Out to Bullock. The three. Well off the mark, Alexis Woods trying for the rebound. No good, and here comes Christian Brothers. Over to Coleman. Coleman over to Jones. Jones thought about the three. Back Sloan Mann down, then back out. Into the corner to Doran. Doran drives out to Emily Jones. Kicks it down low, and Holly Harris comes away with the steal. And we've got a foul away from the ball. That's going to be on Isabella Jones. That is her second, third team foul. So quickly, Christian Brothers with three team fouls here in the third. Alexis Woods takes a seat, and for the first time, we see Jaira Rogers into the game. Rogers going with a mask, having to wear a mask today as well. So Jesse Jennings, the little jumper, good. Jesse Jennings, let's start a fire. 52-39, Chargers trail. Here comes Christian Brothers. Coleman over to Bates. Bates kicks it out to Doran. Doran's going to drive. The little floater rolls out. No good. Ball rolls around. Back over to Bates. And I believe we have an offensive foul. I believe it's going to be on Carly Bates. It is. That is her third. And that is the fourth team foul on Christian Brothers here to start the third. So now we just need the points to go with it. Harris along the right side. Over to Selena Pruitt. The little jumper. Good. Selena Pruitt. It's now an 11-point deficit, 52-41. Chargers crawling back. Christian Brothers, McMath, top being guarded by Selena Pruitt. Chargers staying with that man-to-man defense. Over to Jones. Kicks it over to Isabella Jones. Kicks it out to Doran. Doran over to Isabella Jones for three. Good. That'll stop a run. And we have got a whistle as Yaya Coleman is looking like she has got a little bit of a cramp. She's not moving on the floor, but we've got a timeout. Chargers trailing 55-41. We'll take the timeout with them.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
And welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH, the Chargers. The UAH women take it on Christian Brothers. 6:40 left to go in the third. Chargers trail 55-41. Offensively, UAH coming alive here in the third. The problem, Christian Brothers coming away with a timely basket of their own to answer the UAH run. Holly Harris along the right side. Selena Pruitt thought about the three, drives into the corner, nowhere to go. 13 on the clock, Sloan Mann. 10, Holly Harris over to Jesse Jennings. 7 on the shot clock, 5. Someone's got to be ready. Holly Harris will from the corner. Oh, yes! You betcha! That's the kind of shot that can get us going. Holly Harris for three puts it back in an 11-point deficit. 55-44, 5:55 left to go. Doran along the right side over to McMath. Over to Coleman. Coleman drives wide open lane. The shot blocked by Jaira Rogers. Here comes UAH. Selena Pruitt drives the lane, kicks it out to Sloan Mann. Mann drives, has it taken away. A lot of contact in the lane, but nothing called. McMath loses control. Jesse Jennings, the outlet pass to Selena Pruitt. Pruitt in the lane. Pruitt has it swatted away. So the Chargers have a chance to cut it to single digits on this trip. Jesse Jennings to inbound it to the left side. Gives it in. Holly Harris checks in, or Abby Holly checks back in, kicks it out to Holly Harris, over to Abby Holly. Jesse Jennings trying to kicks it back over to Abby Holly. Harris wide open in that corner. They can't find her. Abby Holly down low to Jaira Rogers, and Jaira Rogers with two. It's the 9-point game. 55-46. Chargers mounting the comeback. Right side. That's going to be Bates over to Doran. Doran drives wide open lane. Hard off the glass. No good. Doran had a wide open lane, and it's too strong. Here comes Jesse Jennings. Kicks it over to Abby Holly. Holly down low to Rogers. Up, and Rogers will head to the free throw line. Jaira Rogers draws a lot of contact, and she will head to the free throw line. Rogers, a 76% free throw shooter. She will shoot them when we return. How about a message from City Cafe?
Want to try something different for breakfast, lunch, or dinner? Then why not head on over to City Cafe Diner? They have the largest menu in the area with traditional breakfast like pancakes and omelets, comfort foods like burgers and shakes, and specialty items like homemade Greek delicacies. And their entire menu is served any time of day. So make plans to dine with City Cafe Diner today, just west of the parkway at 2003 Drake Avenue. City Cafe Diner, where no one leaves hungry.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience a tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Welcome back to the campus of UAH. The UAH women, Christian Brothers, meeting this afternoon. 4:45 left to go in the third. Chargers down 9. A chance to cut into it even more. Jaira Rogers at the free throw line shooting 2. The first one is up and good. Rogers, a 76% free throw shooter. Second one is up and rolls off. But still, the Chargers now trail 55-47. Have to get stops. That's not going to do it. Emily Jones from the corner for 3. Pushes the lead back to 11. Abby Holly down low, off the glass, no good. Christian Brothers the rebound. Over to Emily Jones. Jones racing it across the timeline to McMath. A little pump fake, jumper, good. So five straight points from Christian Brothers. Puts the lead back to 13. And head coach Andrea Lemon taking a timeout.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made of the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by the lawyer.
Ryan Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Ryan Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at BrianBellamyAgency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Brian Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Welcome back to action here. Chargers with the basket, trailing by 11, 60-49. Needing defensive stops. McMath on the left side, drives, kicks it in to the lane, stolen by Jesse Jennings. Chargers don't have numbers. Jennings pulls it up. Takes her time, 23 on the clock. Selena Pruitt gets the Chargers into the offense as they trail 60-49. Miesha Bullock along the right side, trying to find Alexis Woods. Woods double teamed down low, kicks it over to Selena Pruitt. Pruitt drives into the lane, the little left-hand scoop, no good. Ball bounces around, Christian Brothers gonna take it. McMath gonna run right into Miesha Bullock. Bullock, I thought, was there in time. Sure looked like she was there in time. But she's going to get called for the blocking foul. That is the Chargers' first team foul here in the third. That is Bullock's first foul for the game. So Christian Brothers to inbound it along the right's far side. Doran over to Bates. Bates high off the glass, no good. A little spin move there from Bates. Actually, Montgomery. That was Jeremiah Montgomery on the spin. McMath to inbound it. Ball stolen away from Selena Pruitt. Falling out of bounds. Tries to find Holly Harris. And luckily, the ball tipped by Christian Brothers, so UAH maintains possession. I don't understand why the shot clock did not reset. But nonetheless, UAH has possession. Jennings along to Holly Harris along the right side. Kicks it across court to Selena Pruitt. Pruitt will take the wide open three. Boom! You betcha, Selena Pruitt! It's now an 8-point deficit, 60-52, with 2:38 left to go in the third. That is a traveling call on Yaya Coleman. That gives the ball back to the Chargers. So the Chargers can inch even closer, trailing by 8, 60-52. Selena Pruitt across the timeline over to Holly Harris. Harris trying to find Alexis Woods down low. Can't. She's going to drive. Now she does. Harris. Woods up. No good. Stays with it. Back up. No good. Alexis Woods was determined to get that rebound. And she will head to the free throw line. So Woods will head to the line to shoot two. The foul on Jeremiah Montgomery, her second, fifth team foul for Christian Brothers here in the third. First one is up and good for Alexis Woods. So the Chargers now trail just by seven. Woods, the second of two. Good. So Alexis Woods with a pair of free throws now makes it a 60-54 Christian Brothers lead. The Chargers are within six. McMath across the timeline being guarded by Selena Pruitt. Chargers staying in that 2-3 matchup zone. Montgomery drives, nowhere to go. Down low to Coleman. Coleman swings it around for two. Good. Yaya Coleman will swing around. Hook is good and pushes it back up to an 8-point lead. Chargers have a little momentum, though. Holly Harris along the left side. Kicks it over to Selena Pruitt, over to Bullock. Bullock done a drive, has it swatted away, and they're going to say off Miesha Bullock. So the turnover once again gives the ball back to Christian Brothers. They can add to their 8-point lead with a minute 43 left to go here in the third. Along the left side is Bates. Kicks it over to Coleman. Coleman spins into the lane, nowhere to go. The air ball is off the mark. It looks like Jesse Jennings tried to get the ball but stepped out of bounds. That is going to give it back to Christian Brothers. Chargers shooting 53% here in the third. They've outscored Christian Brothers 19-13 here in the third. The problem, Christian Brothers outscored UAH 29-16 in the second. Doran over to Bates. Bates over to Jones. Jones nowhere to go. Kicks it back over to Bates. Bates for three off the mark. And it is going to be Jaira Rogers with the rebound over to Sloan Mann. Blown ahead to Bullock. Bullock trying to go up with it, and she's going to be hacked. So Miesha Bullock will head to the free throw line for two. Foul's going to be on Jeremiah Montgomery, her second. That'll put UAH at the free throw line. So the Chargers coming in as a team, shooting 69% from the free throw line. Here in the third, they are 3 of 4. Christian Brothers has yet to take a free throw attempt here in the third. Bullock's first one is up and good. For the game, the Chargers 10 of 14, 71% from the line. Bullock second up and good. Those are two big ones right there, as it's now a 62-56 game with a minute left in the third. That's going to be Montgomery. The turnaround jumper is off the mark, so the Chargers can pull in closer. Under a minute left to go in the third. Bullock drives into contact. Nothing called. And Sloan Mann, I believe, going to get called for the reach-in. Nope, it's going to be on Miesha Bullock. That is her second. Just the second team foul here in the third by UAH. So it stands 62-56 with 43 seconds left to go in the third. Chargers have had opportunities to get even closer, but just can't quite do it. And Doran's going to drive. She's going to be fouled by Jessie Jennings. So Darcy Doran will head to the free throw line for Christian Brothers. Their first attempts here of the third from the free throw line. So far this game, they are 9 of 11, 81% from the charity stripe. That will win you a ball game or two. Doran's first one is up and rattles in. Doran with one more free throw, and that too rattles around and in. So the Chargers trailing by 8, 64-56. 29 seconds on the game clock, 21 on the shot clock. Holly Harris being guarded by Doran. Kicks it over to Selena Pruitt for three off the back of the iron. No good, but Abby Holly fighting for the rebound. And Holly thought Christian Brothers was the last one to touch it, so she kind of laid up there, didn't go for it, and the ball goes out of bounds. Back over to Christian Brothers. So they'll get the final shot here in the third. That's Bates. Ball's tipped around. And I believe we're going to get a foul on UAH. And I think we just had a jump ball. Actually, the foul is called on Holly Harris. That is her second, fourth team foul. We got another foul away from the ball. That's going to be on Alexis Woods. That is her third. So two big fouls here in the final 5 seconds of the third. One to Holly Harris and the big one to Alexis Woods. That's three for Alexis, so she will sit down for the final 3 seconds here of the third. They're going to need her down the stretch. That is Jeremiah Montgomery at the free throw line, makes the first one. Montgomery with one more off the mark. So they're enjoying a 9-point lead as Holly Harris for the three at the buzzer. No good. So we're going to head to the fourth. Chargers make a little headway. Still a little bit more to go as they trail 65-56 going in to the final frame.
Want to try something different for breakfast, lunch, or dinner? Then why not head on over to City Cafe Diner? They have the largest menu in the area with traditional breakfast like pancakes and omelets, comfort foods like burgers and shakes, and specialty items like homemade Greek delicacies. And their entire menu is served any time of day. So make plans to dine with City Cafe Diner today, just west of the parkway at 2003 Drake Avenue. City Cafe Diner, where no one leaves hungry.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
And welcome back to Spraggins Hall. 10 final minutes on the clock. UAH and Christian Brothers on the women's side. 65-56 your score. The Chargers outscored Christian Brothers in the third, 21-16, as they trail by 9, 65-56 to start this final frame. Down low, Adrian Grant kicks it out to Abby Holly. Holly drives, kicks it out to Selena Pruitt for three. Off the mark, no good. But it is Abby Holly racing down the offensive board. Holly Harris for three. Off the mark, no good. That time, Christian Brothers able to come away with the rebound. Over to Darcy Dorn along the right side. Nearly steps out of bounds. And the little jumper rattles in and out from Coleman. UIH comes away with the rebound. Selena Pruitt forging ahead. Over to Sloan Mann, back over to Selena Pruitt. Pruitt going to set it. Chargers with a little bit of urgency here to start the fourth. Sloan Mann in the lane, finds some open space, goes up, no good. Up again, yes! A lot of contact on that first effort, but nothing called. Selena Pruitt comes away with the steal, but at the same time, looks like she may have jammed that finger. She came away with the steal, and Selena Pruitt instantly goes to the trainer. She is in a little bit of pain there. So out comes Selena Pruitt, Elena Taylor, Holly Harris, Jesse Jennings, Sloane Mann, and Adrian Grant on the floor at the time for the Chargers. Thanks to the steal from Selena Pruitt. Sloane Mann drives, finds some space. The scoop laying hard off the glass, no good. And Christian Brothers comes away with the rebound. So the Chargers had a chance to close that seven-point gap, but couldn't. The three ball, good from Emily Jones. That is just like a dagger from Emily Jones. She now has 20 in the game and the lead back up to 10. So Sloan Mann, here we go, Chargers. We can do it. We can do it again. Holly Harris for three. Well off the mark and the outlet pass. The three ball up and no good from Leanna Pearson. Back comes UAH. Jesse Jennings racing it across the timeline. Has the ball stolen away, but we're going to get a foul away from the ball. That's going to be Jeremiah Montgomery, her third first team foul. Selena Pruitt continues to get that left hand looked at by the trainer. Jesse Jennings, a little jumper off the inbounds, good. So Jesse Jennings now has four in the game. That's going to be Jeremiah Montgomery driving, going to get the foul called. That's going to be on Jesse Jennings, her second first team foul for UAH. So here's your story. Chargers trail by eight with 7:55 left to go in the game. Jeremiah Montgomery at the line, shooting the free throw, is good. Montgomery, an 80% free throw shooter. As a team, Christian Brothers shooting just 72% for the season. And wouldn't you know, Montgomery makes both of them. So for the game, Christian Brothers shooting 82% from the line, 14 of 17. Lena Taylor along the right side over to Sloan Mann. Mann in the lane trying to find some space. Does. Off the glass. No good. But Alexis Woods there for the rebound. And off the mark. But Alexis Woods will head to the free throw line to shoot two. So that's Isabella Jones. That's her third. Second team foul here for Christian Brothers in the fourth. So Alexis Woods at the line to shoot two. The first one is up and rattles in for Alexis Woods. Woods with one more. Woods with 11 in the game. The second one is up and good for Alexis. So Alexis Woods has 12. Chargers trail by eight. 70-62. Let's get a defensive stop. Carly Bates over to Coleman. Coleman nearly has it stolen away. 15 on the clock. Over to Bates. Bates over to Jones. Jones going to drive off the glass. No good. But what's the call? We've got a blocking foul. on Jaira Rogers. I don't know. That's going to be the third on Jaira Rogers. Coach Lemon wants an explanation on that one. That looked awfully close. Awfully close. So Jones heads to the free throw line. No good on the first one from Emily Jones, who shoots free throws at an 85% clip. Jones with one more. Second one up and good. So it's a 71-62 game. Selena Pruitt, the long three. Yes! You betcha! Selena Pruitt for three. There we go! It's now a six-point game. 71-65 with 6:58 left to go. Defense right here. We need a stop. Jones from the corner. Off the mark. Sloan Mann with the rebound. The Chargers can cut into the six-point deficit right here. Trailing 71-65. Bullock drives. Open space off the glass, no good. Fights for the offensive rebound, stays with it. And Bullock gonna be fouled. That is gonna be on Isabella Jones. That is her fourth personal. So the Chargers not shooting yet. It was on the floor, so Sloan Mann to inbound it from the left side. Kicks it out to Selena Pruitt. 19 on the shot clock, over to Mann. Trying to find Alexis Woods down low. She's double-teamed. Pruitt, top of the key. 10 on the shot clock. Pruitt, get him into the offense. Bullock along the left side. Miesha trying to find some space. No good. Over to Jennings for three. Off the glass. No good. That right there, probably not the offensive possession that Andrea Lemon wanted to see. Nonetheless, we'll get a defensive stop right here, and we're okay. 6 minutes left to go. Jones for three, no good. Alexis Woods the rebound. Selena Pruitt brings it across the timeline. Chargers trailing just by six, 71-65. Jesse Jennings, nowhere to go, drives baseline. The little jumper off the glass rolls out, no good. Alexis Woods fights for the rebound, back up and in! Alexis Woods! It's now a four-point game, 71-67. There's Jones, gives it over to Carly Bates. Bates, top of the key, 5:20 left to go, 71-67. Chargers trail by four. Coleman drives. Looks like she got away with a step or two there. And gets it off the glass, 73-67. We got a timeout on the floor. We've got ourselves a ball game inside Spraggins Hall. 73-67, Chargers trail it, but get the momentum. We'll take a timeout.
Want to try something different for breakfast, lunch, or dinner? Then why not head on over to City Cafe Diner? They have the largest menu in the area with traditional breakfast like pancakes and omelets, comfort foods like burgers and shakes, and specialty items like homemade Greek delicacies. And their entire menu is served any time of day. So make plans to dine with City Cafe Diner today, just west of the parkway at 2003 Drake Avenue. City Cafe Diner, where no one leaves hungry.
Tom Luganbill here for Woody Anderson Ford. When I was in the Tennessee Valley, one of the things that impressed me the most was the quality of the people. People like Bobby White and his team at Woody Anderson Ford. And now you can experience the tremendous new service lanes and showroom at Woody Anderson Ford, at Jordan and Sparkman, or just stop by for breakfast or lunch at Henry's Mustang Cafe. And in Madison, visit Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, just south of 72. Like a great college football tradition, always there, Woody Anderson Ford.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Welcome back to Spraggins Hall. 5:13 left to go in this one. UAH and Christian Brothers meeting in women's play. Chargers trailing 73-67. The Chargers have trailed by as many as 17 in this one. They have it down 73-67, down 5. Holly Harris down low to Abby Holly, kicks it out to Miesha Bullock for 3. No good. The fight for the rebound goes Christian Brothers' way. We can get a defensive stop right here. Coleman, the jumper, no good. Hard off the iron. The battle for the rebound, and oh, Holly Harris nearly had it. But Christian Brothers comes away with it, pushing the lead back up to 8. Holly Harris on the right side, 75-67. Harris, the little jumper, too strong. Alexis Woods, the offensive rebound, too strong, no good. Woods tries to fight for it, but can't come up with it. Oh. So, Alexis Woods gonna get a breather. I can't imagine for too long. Jaira Rogers comes in. Rogers playing with that mask on today. There's Carly Bates into the corner for 3. It's Jeremiah Montgomery well off the mark, and the rebound to UAH. Here comes Selena Pruitt pushing the pace. Over to Abby Holly. Holly over to Holly Harris along the right side. Holly thought about the 3. Looks like she stepped out of bounds. That is a turnover. Ball goes back to Christian Brothers. All right. Montgomery to the right side to Bates. The drive from Montgomery over to Jones. Jones, I believe we got away from the ball foul. We do. That's Isabella Jones. That is her 5th personal. So Isabella Jones will check out. Jones with just 8. So Jones checks out with 3:35 left to go. Miesha Bullock along the left side. Over to Selena Pruitt. Christian Brothers in a 2-3 zone. Holly Harris kicks it out to Bullock. Bullock drives wide open lane. Gives it over to Jaira Rogers for 2. Jaira Rogers with the basket. She's got 5, and the Chargers now down 69-75. With 3:10 left to go. That's Emily Jones, drives baseline, met by Miesha Bullock. Bullock wasn't going to let Jones get that easy lay-in. Got her money's worth on that foul, but the problem is that's Miesha's 4th personal. 13 foul. So Emily Jones will head to the line shooting 2. And that time she makes the first one. We mentioned Jones comes in, the leading scorer for Christian Brothers, averaging 19.7 a game. And she's having herself a game here today as Emily Jones. She's got 23 on the afternoon, and it's a 77-69 game. Christian Brothers in front of UAH. Selena Pruitt along the left side. Over to Holly Harris, over to Abby Holly. Back over to Miesha Bullock. Bullock. Selena Pruitt ends up with it along the left side. Drives, kicks it over to Alexis Woods. Up and in! Alexis Woods for 2. It's a 6-point game. 77-71 with 2:40 left to go. Another couple defensive stops, and the Chargers could have this one tied. But that's not going to do it. That will. Off the mark is Jeremiah Montgomery, the wide open lay-in, and the Chargers going to try to take advantage. Selena Pruitt over to Abby Holly, to Holly Harris along the left side. Down low to Bullock. Bullock up strong. Rolls around, no good. Miesha Bullock had a chance and just couldn't quite cash in. Back comes Christian Brothers. Carly Bates gets the Buccaneers into the offense. Picked up by Holly Harris. That's gonna be Coleman bouncing her way in. The scoop from Doran rolls in. Darcy Doran with the little scoop and lay-in. And Andrea Lemon gonna take a timeout. Oh, minute 47 left to go. It's a 79-71 game. The story in this one, every time UAH gets some momentum, Christian Brothers finds a way to answer. We will take a timeout, though, with them.
Hello, Charger fans. This is Cade Smith, UA's Director of Athletics. You're listening to Charger Basketball on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. Keep up with the latest news and photos of all of our teams on uahchargers.com and by subscribing to our email newsletter. Also, don't forget to follow us on social media at UAH Chargers. Thank you for supporting our wonderful student athletes. We look forward to seeing you at one of our upcoming games. Go Chargers.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. Let's set the table for you. 1:47 left to go in this one. The Chargers trailing 79-71. UAH trying to come back. The Chargers have been down by as many as 17 in this one. UAH did lead by 10 early in the first, but an offensive drought for UAH put them in a hole. They've managed to cut the deficit down to 8. They've had plenty of opportunities, but every time Christian Brothers answers a UAH run. So, what does UAH have in store for the final minute 45? Let's find out together. Sloan Mann over to Selena Pruitt. Pruitt over to Holly Harris. Down low to Abby Holly. Holly's jumper off the mark. Alexis Woods, the putback, yes! Alexis Woods has 18 on the game, and it's a 6-point deficit, 79-73. We've been here before. Just a defensive stop or two. That's going to be an offensive foul. That's that arm bar that we see so often in the men's game not get called, but it was called here tonight. It's going to be on Carly Bates. That is her fourth. So with a minute 20 left to go, the Chargers trail by 6. They have a chance to cut it in half. Sloan Mann over to Abby Holly. And Holly going to get called for the double dribble. Lost her dribble, picked the ball up, and then dribbled again. That was an obvious one. So another turnover, costly to the Chargers. Although they don't have as many turnovers here in the second as they did the first. Emily Jones dribbling around, 17 on the shot clock, over to Coleman. Coleman over to Doran. Chargers trail by 6, under a minute left, 79-73. Emily Jones going to drive the scoop. Good. Emily Jones, a wide open lane. Now the Chargers have to hurry. 41 seconds left to go, trailing 81-73. They've got to get something going. They're wasting too much time. Holly Harris going to drive the lane up and no good. Harris stays with it. Over to Selena Pruitt for 3. Off the mark, Holly Harris with the ball. Back over to Selena Pruitt, over to Sloan Mann. 18 on the game clock, 16. The shot clock and game clock pretty much even. And now Andrea Lemon takes a timeout with 13 seconds left to go. Trailing 81-73.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement.
Let's get you back into action. Final 12 seconds of the game. Chargers trailing 81-73. Over to Selena Pruitt. The long three rattles in for Selena Pruitt. Chargers trailing 81-76 with 4.9 seconds left. And Christian Brothers going to call a timeout.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I've personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made. The quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
Ryan Bellamy State Farm Insurance, located in the Rosie's Shopping Plaza, strives to help customers find the best auto insurance, home insurance, life insurance, and more. No matter where you are in life, Ryan Bellamy State Farm Insurance is here to help you find your best insurance and retirement needs. You can find them on the web at BrianBellamyAgency.com or call them at 256-539-7530. Ryan Bellamy State Farm, here to help life go right.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
And welcome back to Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. Chargers down 5 with 4.9 seconds left. 81-76 is your score. Selena Pruitt's 3 just a second ago made it a 5-point game. So Christian Brothers will forward the inbound pass in front of their own bench. And Holly Harris going to foul with 3.6 seconds left. That is going to send Emily Jones to the free throw line to shoot 2. So Emily Jones has had herself a field day today. Oh no, it's not a shooting foul. Chargers with just 4 fouls. So Andrea Lemon choosing to foul there with 4 seconds left, forcing Christian Brothers to inbound it again. And 2, Adrian Grant picks up the foul there with 1.4 seconds left. So that will indeed there send Christian Brothers to the line. That's going to be Jeremiah Montgomery shooting 2. Montgomery with 9 points on the day. And that one rattles in. That there is going to be the difference. 82-76. Chargers just going to run out of time today. 83-76 with 1.4 seconds left. That's going to do it. That's your final from Spraggins Hall. Chargers fall to Christian Brothers 83-76. For Scott Tyson, so long from Spraggins Hall on the campus of UAH. Again, UAH falls to Christian Brothers at home 83-76.